for giving me a few minutes to brag about what you have accomplished this year through the Massage Therapy Foundation, your Massage Therapy Foundation. The mission of the Massage Therapy Foundation is to advance the knowledge and practice of massage therapy through supporting scientific research, education, and community service. Everything we do addresses one or more of those missions. I often encounter some confusion about the relationship between the Massage Therapy Foundation and the AMTA. And this is a natural thing because this relationship is constantly maturing and evolving. The two organizations meet at least once a year to discuss how things are going and to renew our relationship agreement. In 2010, we crafted some language as a public statement to reflect our commitment to each other. And this is the language that now appears on the Foundation's website and also on the AMTA website. It is that the American Massage Therapy Association and the Massage Therapy Foundation share a profound commitment to advance the massage therapy profession through promoting scientific research and evidence-informed practice. Although we are separate organizations, together we endeavor to collaborate as full strategic partners to realize our independent and our interrelated missions. And our relationship will live in
perpetuity!
While the American Massage Therapy Association is committed to financially supporting the work of the Massage Therapy Foundation, both organizations call for partners in funding the foundations in need to promote research literacy and capacity in the profession, to support the evidence-informed practice of therapeutic massage and bodywork based on available research, client factors, and practitioner experience and judgment, to fortify the foundation's financial resources and organizational effectiveness. Our job is to fulfill these goals, which were developed independently, but they tie into the AMTA's research-related vision with our programs. So, here is a brief overview of our programs for fiscal year 2010 and 11. The first one to talk to you about,
I'm so excited about this.
It's the International Journal of Therapeutic Massage and Bodywork. This is your open source, academic, peer-reviewed, scientific journal about massage therapy. It was a big year for the IJTMB because after less than 3 years of publication, this year we were indexed in PubMed Central. This amazing accomplishment was largely due to the efforts of the IJTMB's founding executive editor and shepherd, University of Loyola Professor Dr. Wildman Glenn Mell. Glenn will be here later today. He couldn't make it in time for this morning. I'm so disappointed. Another program that we're continuing to do is teaching research literacy. This is our program that brings a presenter to schools to work with faculty on building research literacy concepts into core curriculum. If you are an educator and you're interested in this program, please let us know and we'll see what we can do to get you hooked up. So let me ask you a quick question. Is there anyone in here who thinks maybe they have a little room to improve their research literacy skills? Have I got a deal for you? Launching this week, we have a brand new program. It's called The Basics of Research Literacy. This is a six-hour online, highly interactive skill-building experience created by Education Training Solutions along with our volunteers who help with the curriculum. They are already known for the quality of their learning experiences. They prepare for this as an ongoing fundraiser. So if you're an educator, yes, this is for you. But if you're a therapist who wants to become more comfortable with research concepts, this is for you too. In addition, our case report contests are in full swing. Student entries are due every October. Practitioner entries are due in March, which means right now, if you get on it, you can have a submission ready for spring. This year's top winners will be presenting their findings this week in the Research in the Profession panel session.
Here are the case report winners for this year. The gold award winner is Rhonda Marie Avery from Ontario. We can go through these a little more quickly. Massage therapy for cervical degenerative disc disease, alleviating a pain in the neck, is not a great title. Let's go, I'll let you read these, and they're also available at our booth. Let's go to the next slide, please. The practitioner case report winner is Rose Chunkle from Plano, Texas, and she did a wonderful case report on ankylosing spondylitis. If you would like to read really the epitome of a really fine case report, I encourage you to read this. Where might you find that? Me? Maybe in the International Journal of Therapeutics. Another one of our very important programs that I'm excited to share with you as it develops is developing best practices. This is a generational investment. Your best practices committee is creating two very important assets for our profession. What we did was, starting in 2010, we gathered input on massage in the context of low back pain and stress, so two different topics, from 30 subject matter experts. We are compiling documents based on that expertise, which will become available for your comment, and we'll post that as soon as those documents are ready. In addition, we are documenting the process of creating this asset so that other stakeholders can pick up this duty of creating best practices for the profession. Having best practice guidelines is a hallmark of any healthcare profession. Last year, we hosted our second research massage conference in Seattle. Now it is time to mark your calendars for April 25th through 27th in 2013 for the International Massage Therapy Research Conference presented by the Massage Therapy Foundation in Boston, Massachusetts. Woo! One of the coolest things about the hotel that we chose in Boston is that you can get there from the airport by a water taxi. I am so proud to tell you that the AMTA has already signed on as a presenting sponsor. This has already set the bar for other sponsors and will help us with our grant writing as well. So thank you. Now let's talk about our research grant. This year, our grant is very exciting. It's happening here in Portland, and it is entitled Massage Impact Chronic Pain in Opioid-Dependent Patients. One of the really exciting things about this grant is that the idea of chronic pain is becoming discussed as a freestanding disorder, and it's on the strategic plan for the National Centers for Complementary and Alternative Medicine. So the fact that we were able to pick up a grant in this field reflects very well on what our profession is doing. We were delighted to be able to give five different community service grants this year. And I'll put up the slide for these. We have free fulfillment, which is about working with prisoners making the transition back into society. That's in Brooklyn, and that is partially sponsored by a gift from the AMTA chapter. We are working in a rural clinic in Costa Rica. This is sponsored for Fame Park by a from Viacom. We're working with very severely poverty-stricken populations in Houston, also with a gift from Viacom. We're working with a program called Soothing Our Senior Clients in New Jersey. And our last one is Massage Therapy for Orphans in Japan, sponsored by a gift from the AMTA Massachusetts chapter. Speaking of our community service grants, I am really excited to let you know that one of our grants last year was happening right here in Portland. We have a guest, Heidi Pankey, is here from to give us a few words about her experience.
Thank you. is with your support. Last year, we had a special campaign to celebrate our 20th anniversary. Does anyone here remember what that was?
25.
What does that look like? This year, it's our 21st anniversary. We decided not to have a campaign with a drink lifted. So we're going to do something different. We would like to let you know that we have created this beautiful Massage Therapy Foundation donor pin. It is only available this week. With your support, we'd love for you to have a pin. Ask any volunteer or foundation staff person. The pins are $20, and all the cool people will be wearing them.
Do you guys have yours on?
Talk about the hook.
The purchase of the pin will also get you a raffle ticket for the quilt. Yeah. Next, our very great thanks goes out to Celia Bucci and 23 generous artists who contributed their music to our very first fundraising CD.
Nice.
This two-disc set is here. It's hot off the presses. Rise is music of all genres and all by massage therapists. Shine is music for massage, also by massage therapists or artists who specialize in music that we use. I'm pleased to remind you, the Rise and Shine CDs are on sale at the booth. They are, I think, $15 for one, $25 for two. Christmas is coming. I am pleased to let you know I did manage to finish the quilt for this year. Raffle tickets are $5 or 5 for 20 at the foundation booth. And while you're there getting your pin and your raffle tickets, you can also get the answer sheet for our QR code treasure hunt. Michael Reynolds from SpinWeb has been tremendously generous by organizing and donating a Kindle for this project. Thank you, Michael. So for details on how this works, visit us at the booth because you won't want to miss it. And of course, while you're in the hall, please take a break at the sanctuary. This is an undertaking led by Massage Warehouse. This year, some of the Massage Therapy Foundations and rock stars of the massage world will be volunteering along with students to give massage in the sanctuary. So don't miss out on this once-in-a-lifetime chance to have Diana Thompson rub your feet. First, this year we also have our post-convention workshop. This year with the incomparable Gail Pedley. It's not too late to sign up for this. It runs Sunday and Monday. Come see us for details if you can make it. Yesterday we had our very first Massage Therapy Foundation golf outing. Great participation from golfers and sponsors alike. We're going to work on doing it again next year in Raleigh. So make your plans to come the gate early and swing a club with us. In closing, I want to encourage you to remember that the Massage Therapy Foundation, this is your foundation. Our annual gift from the AMTA National covers our staff, our overhead, and some of our other operational costs. And this means that more of your individual gift goes to your research grants and your community service projects and your journal and your literacy classes, and your case report contests, and your best practices initiatives. These are your resources. They're resources for the whole profession. The more you use them, the more we all advance. The Massage Therapy Foundation is proud to work with the AMTA, our primary benefactor, our founder, our strategic partner, to make these programs come to life. Thank you for your time today. And have a wonderful week.